Do you feel like you have a fair understanding of regular expressions and yet you always struggle to apply what you know? Do you search the internet for regular expressions you need only to find that everything you've got is either wrong or incomplete or not appropriate for the problem you are solving? In this video, I will show you a step-by-step process that will help you develop regular expressions of whatever complexity you need. If you follow these steps every time, your regular expressions will always be correct and appropriate for the problem you are solving. The first step in developing any regular expression is to see the data. You must have the data you want to match before thinking about the regular expression. Here is the example problem I will be solving. This is not a realistic example. I will be developing a regular expression that will parse the CSV, comma separated values, file. There are CSV readers around and you will not write this regular expression ever in your career, but the process of developing a CSV parser is very indicative when talking about regular expressions. So starting from the data means to isolate all special cases, all forms you're interested to match and parse. When speaking of CSV, you see regular values, but also the values that contain a comma. A comma is a separator, so these cells containing a comma will have to be quoted in the CSV file. And here is another special case, double quotation sign. Let me show you what this file looks like when I save it to disk. This is the plain text, the CSV, comma separated values file. And you see the regular cell, then the cell which contains a comma, which is put under double quotation marks, and the cell which also contains the double quotation mark, so it is put under quotations, but every double quotation inside of it is doubled itself to be escaped effectively. So I want to parse these values using a regular expression. This is the web application I'm using to develop regular expressions myself. It is the regex101.com website. I have been using it for years. It is free for use. And it is very useful. It has very useful features. This text box here is where you put your raw text, the text you will be parsing, you will be matching with a regular expression. Then you look into the text and think, we are thinking about developing the regular expression, right? The regular expression for what? For isolating cells inside the table. And what do we see? We see that all cells end in a comma, except those at the end of the line. We don't like exceptional cases. They make ugly regular expressions, needlessly complex ones. So before writing the regular expression, you can try to change, to tweak the data to make it simpler. Why don't we add a comma at the end of every line so that we make every cell have a comma afterwards? And now the final step before starting to develop the regular expression, I will put all those data on a single line because I will be parsing one line at a time. Also, this site, regex101, is supporting multiple programming languages. You can select the programming language for which you are developing the regular expression. I will select C#, dotnet C# here in the list. The regular expression has changed to verbatim string format of C#. That is very important because sooner or later you will be copying and pasting your regular expression into code. And when you do that, you will have to satisfy the rules of the programming language you are using, which means to escape special characters from inside the regular expression. Well, guess what? That's where we make mistakes. This is a very useful feature because you will write the regular expression appropriate for the programming language where you will be using it. It is C# here. I'm ready to start constructing the regex here. I already expect that you know the basic regex syntax. This is not the tutorial on regular expressions. In this video, I want to show you the process of applying what you know about regular expressions. The data are there, and we can try whatever comes first to mind. For example, pick anything that is not a comma as an experiment. Each colored block under in the text is a single match. And as you can see, commas were not matched. They are still white. But okay, let's stop playing and start doing real things. I want to match the first cell, this one, 1 and the comma. That's the first cell in the data. I want to match that. It begins with anything but a double quotation mark. It's very important. Double quotation mark is a different case. And it must not start with a comma as well. So we need anything that is not a special character in CSV. Then it is followed by anything that is not a comma, 0 or multiple times, and it ends up in a mandatory comma. This expression, however simple, has matched the entire first cell in the data. I do have troubles with the second cell, though. The second cell is under double quotation marks. So let's match that one too with a large unified expression so that the regular expression matches both the first and the second cell in the data. I don't want to ruin what I have created already. So I will put a pipe here and construct an alternative to the first expression for the data that were not matched by the first expression. It will begin with a mandatory double quote, but since this is the verbatim string of C#, I need to double quote here. But in the regular expression, that is a single double quote. I hope you're not confused by this, but you must do it right here. And it is good that whatever you do, you will have a feedback right away, long before you move to actual C# code, where any mistakes might be obscured. You might not be able to see them. Double quote followed by anything but a double quote, 0 or more times, including a comma, observe that, ending up in a mandatory double quotation mark, doubled again for C# purposes, followed by a mandatory comma. This expression is matching the first and the second cell right, but I have a problem with the cell that has a double quotation mark inside. You see, the CSV format is escaping a contained double quotation mark by doubling it itself, so it is a double quotation mark inside CSV text. Let's support this kind of CSV as well. Inside the quoted cell, there will either be a non-double quotation mark or an escaped double quotation mark. It is a double quotation, but for a verbatim C# string, it will be quadruple double quotation mark. The quoted cell with quotation marks inside of it is now matched. I only have a problem with an empty cell. This one here is not matched yet. So let's add an alternative, an empty cell, which just consists of a comma. The expression is now correct. Now we improve the expression. We deal with other requirements, the non-functional requirements. For example, comma is mandatory in all sub-expressions here. Why not remove it from all the sub-expressions? Group them to be one sub-expression and then follow it with a comma. I didn't break the expression, that's the important part. But now, there are too many colors below for my taste. What are those colors? Those are the captured groups. I don't want to capture anything at this stage. Also, capturing groups, these parentheses, they cost. They cost us performance. You can tell the regular expression not to capture the groups by using the question mark and colon so that you turn these groups into so-called non-capturing groups. The text coloring is uniform again, which means that the regular expression didn't capture anything. But we do need capturing. We want to extract the data from the text. This one group here, that is the content of the unquoted cell in CSV. I will call it plain. That will be the plain text. And also, that empty text, it is also a plain text. It should be an empty string. Let me move it into this named capturing group. This is not the only way to do this. You can use the quantifier 0 or 1, the question mark. It doesn't matter. You can do that as an exercise. I don't care. The point is that I'm developing this regular expression, trying not to break it, not to make a mistake. Let's finish it. The last part is the quoted cell, and I will give that one a name as well. I will call it double quoted. It requires post-processing. During the post-processing, we will have to unescape double quotation marks of CSV format to turn it into single double quotation marks of the final text. This ends the process of constructing the regular expression. I hope you liked it so far. Please press the like button. Thank you. At this stage, we have a regular expression that works. You can use this application to generate code for you. This is a valid C# code, but not so useful, I'm sorry. You will see there will be a lot of code to work around using that regular expression. I think I will only take the regular expression from this generated code. At least that is useful. It is very good if a machine could do that for us as it did here. All right, this is the application that needs that regular expression. This demo class is mimicking some file loaded from the disk, and it pretends to be loading lines of text from somewhere. I will use it as a data source. And then, whatever the application is doing that you need the regular expression to implement, that application will be doing not with the data, not with strings, not with the regular expressions. It will be working with some business domain objects. I called it a spreadsheet here. That's what I need. And all I've got is the sequence of raw lines of CSV text. I need something to bridge that gap in between. And so here is the builder. I'm showing you all this because you need to understand that there is a lot of code besides the raw text and the regular expression. There is already a model in your application. And so, when it comes to using regular expressions in your code, it is a good practice to close them into a separate block of code, a class, for example. This is the class which will parse the CSV document. There's a lot of code here. If you want to download the source code, visit me on my Patreon page. It's all there. You can download the source code from my Patreon page. Because now, I will be implementing this application to the end. This method should parse all the lines into a builder, the spreadsheet builder. And this method's responsibility is to parse one line at a time, because eventually we will be parsing one line at a time. We'll be applying the regular expression to a single line at a time. Let's implement them and you will see what they will do. The first one will be parsing many lines by iterating through them and trying to parse each one of them in isolation. If that failed, there's no purpose in continuing further because the builder will already have an error set. So we quit. That is very simple. The crux of this application, the CSV parser in this application, is the second method. Parsing a CSV line using that regular expression we developed means to find all the matches one after another without gaps in between, because if there is a gap, it means that something was not matched with the regular expression we have prepared, and that is the error. Therefore, I will remember the last position processed so far, tell the builder that I'm starting the new row in the data in the table. I will then paste that regular expression I developed earlier. That is why I copied it from there, so that I don't type anything here. I just don't want to type
this kind of code.
Also, force its compilation that will make the regular expression faster. Mind you, today in C-sharp, you can use a source generator that will parse and compile the regular expression and even build a custom class for the state machine for your custom regular expression at compile time. There's no faster way of doing regular expressions than that one. In this example here, I don't expect any performance penalty, so I didn't do it here. But if you require short startup time and highest performance, then look for source generator for regular expressions in C-sharp and see if they are useful to your application. I want to apply the regular expression to the entire line and see all the matches, but don't forget to add the comma at the end of the line because the regular expression I'm implementing requires a comma at the end. And now inside the loop, analyze what the match has told us. If it creates a gap, then we have stumbled upon an error in the input data and we must report it in the builder so that eventually the caller will see that there is the problem with the data. Otherwise, if there's no gap, append the captured value. But what does it mean, append the extracted value? Look at this helper method below. It analyzes the group that was captured. If it was the double quoted group, then look what it does. It is dequoting. It is removing double quotation marks, replacing them with a single double quotation mark each. Otherwise, it must be a plain value and just take it. So this is the post-processing step after the regular expression was matched against the input text. Below the loop, we must check if we have got the end of the line. Those are the small nuances that you must do when using a regular expression to parse your data, to match the data. And that is also the reason why we want to have this regular expression and everything that works around it wrapped into a single class that knows how to deal with that regular expression alone. Because when you do it that way, nobody else will see any of that dirt. This is the program, the main function. It is the ultimate consumer. It will parse the data loaded from the raw document. If the builder can build the spreadsheet, then build it and print it out. Otherwise, show the error stored in the builder and let the user rectify the data. When I run this demo application, you will see that all the data are there. They are parsed. All the data are here, parsed by the regular expression. And the main takeaway from this demo is that I have prepared that regular expression in a highly controlled process. Develop the regular expression step by step until you cover all the special cases in the data. Then move it to your program, but make sure not to mix regular expression matching logic with anything else because it will be dirty. Wrap it into a class, expose a simple, plain interface towards taking the data matched and extracted using the regular expression and then use it in your domain model like a SERP. I hope you learned something new from this demo. Like it, share it, and visit me on Patreon, download the source code and read what I have made. Thank you for staying till the very end and see you in the next episode.